A warm evening to all of you. So with an immense pleasure and gratitude, I would like to welcome you all to our YLP session number 7 on behalf of Bahrain Panbaravel Toastmasters Club. And here, without any further delay, with the grace from Almighty, we'll start our meeting. I would like to call our YLP Sergeant at Arms, Prince Calvin, to kindly start over the meeting. Young leader Prince Calvin, all is yours. Thank you.
Oh, distinguished Toastmasters, respected guests, and my dear young leaders, good evening all. This is Prince Calvin, Sergeant at Arms of Youth Leadership Program. Take an immense pleasure in welcoming you all to our meeting number 7. Here are the few protocols to be respected during the meeting. Please keep your audio muted until prompted or when your turn comes. Please turn off all noise-making devices or put them on silent mode during the session. Speakers are requested to refrain from making any references to politics, sex, or religion in their speeches. Attendees are requested to stay in the session until the end to motivate our young leaders. Please enter or exit only during the applauses. Thanks a lot. With no further delay, let's begin the meeting by starting the mission of Youth Leadership Program. We provide a supportive and positive learning experience in which young leaders are empowered to develop communication and leadership skills, resulting in greater self-confidence in personal growth. Now it's time to welcome our president, young leader Shivani, to call the meeting to order is preside the session. Welcome, President.
Thank you, young leader Prince Calvin. Good evening to one and all. I would like to call the meeting number 7 of Bahrain Panbaravel Toastmaster Club Youth Development Session to order. It's my privilege and pleasure to welcome all the Toastmasters, fellow young leaders, and guests. I take an immense pleasure in welcoming our gender evaluator of today's event, T.N. Tamilselvi. Education is most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world, quoted by Nelson Mandela. Education is an essential asset of life, growth and development. With education comes the power to learn and implement. Education plays an essential role in character building as well as in shaping the personality of individuals. It shows us the importance of hard work and at the same time help us to grow and develop. Education expands our vision and creates awareness. It helps us to develop a disciplined life and provides us with better earning opportunity. Education is not preparing for life. Education is life itself. As a president, I would like to thank you all for attending our youth development session today. We have 4 energetic speakers and we hope everyone will participate in either the meeting roles or the table topic session. Now let's move on to the business session. Now let's welcome our VP Education, Young Leader Nasmin. Over to you, Young Leader Nasmin.
For your notice, Young Leader Shivani, she couldn't join with us today because of her internet issue. So kindly you proceed with the further roles. Thank you. Over to you.
Let's welcome our secretary, Young Leader Kanishka. Over to you, Young Leader Kanishka. Let's welcome us. Over to you.
Are you available? Kanishka?
Hi, yes, ma'am. Due to network issues, I couldn't, I got disconnected.
No issue, yeah. You can proceed with, yeah.
Yes, ma'am. evening, distinguished Toastmasters, privileged guests, and young leaders. As a secretary, I will maintain the club records, manage the club files, handle club correspondence, and take the minutes of the meeting at each club and executive committee meeting. I will be also in charge of updating and distributing a roster of current paid membership and keeping the club officer list current for Toastmaster International. Though some clubs combine the secretary role with the treasurer, it's best to have a dedicated secretary who can help reduce the workload of treasurer and occasionally assist the vice president education as well. I will also order the supplies for the.
Thank you, young leader Kanishka. Now let's welcome our secretary at arms, young leader Prince Calvin. Over to you, young leader Prince Calvin.
Thank you, President, young leader Shivani. Once again, good evening and warm greetings to all. As of now, no physical meeting is conducted. Physical arrangements were not been done. But then too, virtually, I look for establishment of quorum before starting the meeting. And I am maintaining the attendance of every sessions of YLP. At the same time, I will assure you that I will deliver my duties most responsibly once after this crisis ends. And I am eagerly looking forward for that. Thank you. Over to President, young leader Shivani.
Thank you, young leader Prince Calvin. Let's welcome our PPR young leader Gautam. Over to you, young leader Gautam.
Good morning, everyone. As the YLP VPPR, my responsibilities are to promote the club to eligible guests and notify the media regarding the club's assistance and benefits, develop and maintain club social media pages and website, write new releases and distribute marketing materials, create club policy campaigns, ensure the club content and meaning information is up to date in Club Central, understand the importance and impact of the Toastmasters brand, update web content and safeguard the Toastmasters brand, remain current with the leader letter, Toastmaster magazine, and Toastmasters international social media channels. Thank you. Over to the president.
Thank you, young leader Gautam. Let's start this meeting by having our MC Jeevita. She's studying in 7th grade in Indian school and her hobbies are dancing, cooking, reading, gardening, drawing. And her ambition is to become the Prime Minister of India. Best wishes to all the speakers. Over to you, MC. The stage is yours.
Thank you, President. Honored guests, fellow Cavaliers and Toastmasters, a very warm good evening to one and all. Let's start the session 7 with a small story which we all very well know. The Thirsty Crow. It was summer. The day was very hot. A crow was very thirsty and he looked for water here and there. But he couldn't find any. At last, he saw a small pot with very little water in it. He tried to reach it, but he could not. He got an idea. He picked up stones and dropped them in the pot. The water came up and the crow drank the water and flew away happily. By this, we can see that the crow was in need for water. So he found that when stones are dropped in the water would come up. In the same way, in prison, what are scientists working on? They are working to find a cure for COVID. Why are they doing so? It is only because it is a need. Long ago, transportation was poor. In that case, how was aircraft invented? It was only invented because it was in need. Pensiveness is one of the main criteria for all inventions so far. A need or problem encourages creative efforts to meet the need or solve the problem. So young leader, be pensive and be an inventor in future. Necessity is the mother of invention. It's a well-known proverb. It means roughly that the primary driving force for most new invention is a need. In the Socratic Dialogue, Republic, Plato famously wrote, our need will be the real creator, which was molded over time into the English proverb, necessity is the mother of invention. The tremendous urge in man to lead better lives drives him to make invention. The cycle has been going on since Stone Age. Man has always used his necessity as his drive to make something new. Men are ambitious creatures, and they discover and conquer new areas to earn better lives for themselves and others. We must realize that men do not create things because they want to. They build them because they need to. Even if we consider the most basic needs, such as hunger and shelter, we will see that we invented food and houses only because it is in need. Abraham Maslow has shown in his need hierarchy how men always work towards satisfying his needs. We must understand how dependent we are on our desires and how they help us create a better and more progressive world. The need and desire of man make the earth a better place is the driving force behind all invention. Do you all get full marks in your math exam every time? Very rarely if you are lucky. You will, but what if you're not lucky enough? I now invite Sir Dhakeshwar to tell us some Vedic math. He is an aptitude faculty from the Institute of Chennai Rail and has 6 years of experience. Sir, the floor is yours.
Mr. Dwarakeshwar, are you available? Mr. Dwarakeshwar? Mr. President, can we proceed with?
Yes, we can proceed.
Okay. So, MC, we can go ahead. He will join us soon, I think. So, meanwhile, if he come back, we'll have a session.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, thank you.
Now, join me in calling our grammarian, who is going to tell everyone about the special things used in our speeches. Let us welcome young leader Faisal Rahman. He is studying in grade 6 in the new Indian school. We must be careful with him as he knows karate and is an orange belt holder. He is interested in origami, clay modeling and cycling. Let's give him a round of applause. Over to young leader Faisal.
Thank you, MC. Respected Toastmasters, fellow young leaders and guests, a very good morning once again. As a grammarian, it is my responsibility to note everything during the meeting, to report any particular effective uses of grammar and any grammatically incorrect speeches as well. Example, I may point out when someone says there are so much people instead of there are so many people. Likewise, we met 3 years before instead of we met 3 years ago. As a grammarian, it is also my task to present the word of the day for this beautiful session. The word is pensive. I repeat, the word is pensive. Pensive means engaged in deep and serious thought. I request everyone, especially the session participants, to use the word of the day, pensive, as much as possible. I will give the word of the day usage report and grammatical usage report when called for. Thank you. Over to MC.
Thank you, young leader Faisal Rahman. I got it. I now invite our counter, young leader Sai Arun. He is studying Alagappa Academy School in 3rd standard. He is pensive in playing with his brother Guru Krishna. He is the captain of yellow football team. He is also pensive in playing chess and cards with his father. He loves to travel, but due to this pandemic, he is not able to. We will all pray that this pandemic gets over soon. Young leader Sai Ravin, the floor is yours.
Thanks for our useful introduction, MC. Good evening, young leaders and senior Toastmaster, respected mentors. The purpose of the encounter is to not any repeated words. Such as sounds maybe account thank you. Over to NC.
Thank you, young leader Sai Ravin. Time is very precious. We must not waste time, nor just leave it. I would like to invite our timer, young leader Akash. He is studying in the New Millennium School and is interested in badminton, art and craft too. Over to young leader Akash.
Thank you, Master Selmi. Good evening to all Toastmaster, young leaders and guests. As a timer, I will time table topic, speech speakers, formal speakers and evaluation. I will also alert each speaker of the time they have left using green, yellow and red background, which denotes specific time remaining. Table topic speakers should limit their remarks to no more than 2 minutes. At 1 minute, I'll display green color. At 1 minute, 30 seconds, I'll display yellow color. At 2 minutes, I'll display red color. Those giving speeches should limit their time remarks to their specific times. All speakers should be 4 to 6 minutes in length. At 4 minutes, I'll display green color. At 5 minutes, I'll display yellow color. At 6 minutes, I'll display red color. The individual evaluation should be between 2 to 3 minutes. At 2 minutes, I'll display green color. At 2 minutes and 30 seconds, I'll display yellow color. At 3 minutes, I'll display red color. Thank you. Over to Master of Ceremony.
Thank you, young leader Akash. Let's move on to education session. Let's invite our first speaker, young leader Amitha Varshini.
Sorry for the interruption, MC Jeevita. So here we are having Dwarakesh sir with us.
Yeah, he is with us.
Yeah, so since he is joining us from India, so let us provide him first time to have a wonderful workshop from him. Can we hear it from Dwarakesh sir? Sir, you are muted, sir.
Now can you hear me?
Yes, sir. Yes, we can hear you. You can go ahead with your presentation, sir. Thank you, sir.
Can I? Yeah, thank you. Yes, good evening, all. I'm your aptitude trainer. So I have been training the students for the last 6 years in this field. So it will be quite comfortable for you to be cope up with me as well. So one thing I request before proceeding the concepts, you have to interact with me. That is a major part that I need from your side. You have to interact with me. Why I'm asking this is, then only I will come to know that whether you understood the concept what I taught or not, right? So on that basis, this session will be completely going to be an interactive session. Unless until if it is not interactive, I cannot know that whether you understood the concepts what I taught clearly or not. So my first request is you have to reply with it, right? So the second thing, so let me start with the file. I wanted to share a file, ma'am. Can I share the file right now?
Is it accessible
for me, ma'am?
Yeah, you'll be given access, sir, from our president. Mr. President, can we have a screen access for him?
Yeah, it's done.
So it's done, sir.
Yes, I hope everyone could see the PPT what I'm sharing.
Yes, sir.
For me, so that I'll proceed. Yeah, okay. Today's topic is Vedic Maths. So Vedic Maths is one of the, not a modern topic actually, this is an ancient topic. So right from the birth of Vedic Maths is right from India. So in our India, the ancient sages or the saints or the mathematicians or the astronomers, those persons introduced Vedic Maths for us. So it is not a modern technology or modern concepts. The Vedic Maths is completely an ancient one. So why we need to learn Vedic Maths? So quite the scenario, out of this present scenario, the calculations what you are doing here will be, we need to use pen or pencils to do it. But when you're going with Vedic Maths concepts, you no need to. 90% of the problems can be solved without using the pen or pencil, just by doing the calculations mentally. So that is a major part of Vedic Maths, right? So here in this particular session, I'll be teaching you a particular concept, which is nothing but square values, because I cannot cover all the entire topics. Here I had listed out the different topics or different cases in Vedic Maths. So first, square values, square roots, cube roots, different types of multiplication. This one particular section, different types of multiplication alone deals with seven different types of addition. Subtraction addition is somewhat hard. All these four parts is also easy, but it is the most important than the last two. So the first four is very, very important for our mind calculations. So first, I'll start with square values. So let's move on to the topic of square value. So guys, before starting this particular concept, square value, I want to ask you one thing.
Sorry, your voice is breaking.
Is my face clear for everyone? Or do I need to increase my fast? Or do I need to reduce the fast? Is it okay for everyone? Can you cope up with me? Hello?
Sir, actually, you may have some internet issue, I think. We couldn't hear you properly. Your voice is completely breaking, sir. Other than that, your training is going fine. But we are facing problem with your connection, I think. So we couldn't hear you properly.
1 second, ma'am. I'll just check my connection.
Yes, sir.
I'll come back from the first. I'll share my screen once again. Ma'am, now am I audible clearly?
Yes, sir. You are.
Yeah. So first, as I said earlier, we are going to start with the concept of square values. Students, I want you need to do something. That is, when you are learning the concept of square value, the first thing, I'm going to teach you the square values through the mental calculations. Before teaching that, I want you to memorize the square values from 1 to 30. Actually, you have to memorize. This is the mandatory part. There is no shortcut for doing this, because our shortcut will entirely depend upon the square values from 1 to 30. So you have to memorize 1 to 30 squares. But don't worry, I'll make you to memorize 1 to 30 squares. But as of us from your side, you have to do your part. For 1 to 20, I had listed out the square values for 1 to 20 here. That is 1 square is 1, 2 square 4, so up to 10 square. 10 square is 100. This is very simple for us. 1 to 10, it's very simple. The next one is from 11 to 20. It will be somewhat difficult for you, because some of you may not come across those values. It's not a problem at all. But if you are coping, or if you are following the values regularly, that will be more easy for you. So what is the first one? 11 square, 121, 12 square, 144, then 13 square, 169. Just simply memorize those values, right? So fine. So 1 to 20, there is no shortcut. You have to memorize it barely. That is a part from your side. You have to do it. The next thing, what I'm going to do is, I'll share you a simple technique from 21 to 30, or 21 to 30, how to memorize those values. I'll share you a simple technique, right? Yes, fine. So first, I'll start with 21 square. The value of 21 square is 441. The value of 21 square is 441, right? So 21 square is 441. The next one is 29 square. So 21 and 29 are pairs. So 21, it's 441. 29, it is 841. So look at the last two digits. It is 41 and 41, right? So 21 square, it is 441. 29 square, it is 841. So it is ending with 4141 in the two digits. So we can say these two are a pair. Then 23 square, it is 529. 27 square, it is 729. Again, look at the last two digits. The last two digits are very similar, right? 23 square, 529. 27 square, 729. The last two digits are same. Similarly, 22 square, 28 square, 484 and 784. Again, look at the last two digits. The last two digits are similar. Similarly, the last two cases, 24 square and 26 square, which is nothing but 576 and 676. Again, the last two digits are same for us. So this is the technique for 21 to 30 square, right? 30 is very simple. 30 square, the value we can directly say it is 900. 30 is very simple, as well as 25 is also very simple. 25 square is directly
the voice is breaking.
Your voice is lagging.
That is the value of 625, right? So 25. Can you confirm me? Is it clear? So that I'll proceed further on.
So your voice was lagging.
Sir, your voice was lagging in the middle.
It's lagging. So now is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Now it is okay.
Yeah. Okay, fine. I'll ask you a simple question. Are you clear with up to what I taught? Are you clear with this?
Yes.
Is there any doubts or any issues up to this? So can I ask you the questions up to what I taught? Is it okay for everyone?
Okay, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So first, what I said is 1 to 20 squares, you have to memorize it. There is no shortcut for it, right? But from 21 to 30, there are some simple shortcuts to memorize the values. So first, I'll ask you the simple question. 21 is paired with which number? 21 and which number is getting paired?
29 squared.
Yeah, very good, very good. What's the value for 21?
441.
What's the value for 29?
841.
What is the similarity between the two numbers? Why we are making the two numbers as a pair?
The last two digits ending with 41.
So, right. Similarly, what's the value for 24 square?
576.
Similarly, 26 square is 676. Again, the last two digits are similar. So, up to this, you are clear, right? So, you can easily understood what I taught, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So, thank you. So, now let's proceed the technique. First, I'm going to teach you the traditional method to find the squares of any numbers. Later, after completing this traditional method, I'll introduce the shortcut method for 31 to 130. Okay. So, first, we are going to look after the traditional method. By using this traditional method, what you can do is you can try to find the squares for any numbers. It's not here in a shortcut. It is that we have a restriction. The restriction is 31 to 130. But when you're applying the traditional method, you don't have any restrictions. So you can apply it for any numbers, right? For example, if you need to find the value for 213 square, you can also apply the traditional method and you can find it. But the traditional method, the difficulty here is the calculations, the calculative part. Here, the calculations involves, there is more calculations in the traditional method. That is one thing difficult over here. But in the shortcut method, we won't have any calculations. We do have calculations, but those calculations are very basic in nature, a very simple addition and subtraction, right? So those are the calculations will be involved in shortcut method. But in traditional method, hectic, we'll be having some hectic calculations, but not a problem at all, right? But in your schoolings or in your exams, you won't find a very big number as like what I said, 213 square. You won't find those numbers in your exams, right? So we can leave those difficult numbers because obviously it won't come in our exams. But the values which may come in our exam will definitely fall within 31 to 130. That is our task. So within 31 to 130, you have to be fast enough to find the squares of those values. That's the reason why for 31 to 130, we are using the shortcut method. Clear? For traditional method, even though I'll be teaching you the traditional method, just listen carefully. So let me introduce it. I had written a simple idea over the PPT. Just look at the ideas. A plus B the whole square, right? Please don't look at the screen. Can anyone say, everyone, can you say me the value for the formula of A plus B the whole square?
Can I?
Anyone can say the formula.
A plus B the whole square is equal to A square plus 2AB plus B square.
Yeah, very good. A square plus 2AB plus B square, right? So A square plus 2AB plus B square. But look at the formula, what I had written on the screen. I haven't used the plus symbol in between A square, 2AB and B square, isn't it? Is it clear for everyone what I am saying?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I haven't used the normal addition sign. Instead, what I'm using is I'm using a separator symbol, right? A square is separate, 2AB is separate, and B square is separate. Means we have three different columns. The first column has A square, the second column has 2AB, and the third column has B square, right? Now, I had taken an example over here. Look at the example. The example is 46 square, right? The example is 46 square. In any number, listen this point. It is an important point. In any number, always the unit's place is represented by B. The unit's place is represented by B. And the tens, the remaining number, not only the tens number, remaining number, right? So remaining number is represented with we can say A, right? The remaining number is represented with A. For example, 46, this is your unit's place. This unit's place is 6. This is represented by B. And this is our remaining number. It is represented with A. For example, if I consider 123, in 123, which is B, which number is represented by B? Can anyone say which number is represented by B?
3.
Very good. The unit's place 3 is represented by B. And which is your A? Is it 2 or is it 12?
12.
Actually, remaining number. Remaining number should be considered as A. So it is 12. It's not just 2. It is 12. The remaining number is A. Am I clear for everyone? Right? Yes, fine, guys. Now, let's proceed the procedure how to find the value. Now, listen. As I said, the unit's place is B square and the remaining number is A square. Let's substitute the value of A and B in the formula. First column, A square. What's the value for A? It is 4. Everyone know the value of 4 square. What's the value of 4 square? It is 16. Right. Very good. Next is 2AB. That is 2 into A into B. Right. So 2 into A. The value of A is 4. And the value of B is 6. So 2 into 4 into 6. So 2 into 4. It is 8. 8 into 6. The value is what for us? 48. Is everyone clear with the multiplication? Basic multiplication. Is there any doubt in multiplying 2, 4 and 6? Is it okay for everyone?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Very good. Yes, sir. Yeah, okay, fine. And the last column, the third column is B square. The value of B square is 6 square. 6 square is what for us? 36. Clear? Right. So the first column is 16. The second column is 48. And the last column, the third column is 36 for us. Right. Now, here comes an important point. So listen carefully to this point. The important point is we have values in three columns. From the left hand side, that is from this side, I have to start from the left hand side. While starting, we need to consider only the unit's place, or we need to take only the unit's place from each column, right? For example, in 36, I had underlined that 6, right? Means I'm taking only 6, only the unit's place. So I'm taking the 6 and I'm placing here. What's the remaining I have? Remaining is 3, right? So now listen carefully, I'll ask you a question. Now that remaining 3, I'm going to add it with the next column. I'm going to add that 3 with the next column. Then what's the next column? 48. Can anyone say what is the value of 48 plus 3?
51.
Very good. 51. In 51, again, in 51, what is the number in the unit's place?
One.
We need to consider only one. So next to 6, what's the value I have is 1. Am I right? So one. I had placed 1.
Yes.
In that 51, we placed 1. What's the remaining we have?
Five.
Yeah. That 5 should be the carry for what? 16. That 5 should be the carry over for 16. So 16 plus 5, what's the value? 16, not 60. It is 16. 16 plus 5, 21. What's the value?
21.
Very good. Very good. That is the number I had placed over here. So we can say finally, the value of 46 square is nothing but 2116, right? Right, fine. But this is the traditional method. By using the traditional method, you will be finding some calculations, right? So for example, here the calculation is what? 2 into 4 into 6. That becomes us 48. The next, we need to add the 3 with 48, add this 5 with 16. So there are some calculations, right? So to get rid of those calculations, what we are going to do is we are going to approach with the shortcut method. Guys, before entering into the shortcut method, let me ask you again the same thing. That is, are you clear with the concept what we discussed right now? Any doubts do you have up to this?
No, sir.
Yeah, is it clear? No, no, in the sense you are not clear.
No, no, sir. No doubts, I think.
Okay, fine. Very good. Yes. So that I'll proceed to the next one. So let's move on to the next case. Yeah. Now we are coming into the shortcut method. So guys, listen carefully. This is the most important part, and this is the core of today's session, right? So this is the part you need to listen keenly. This is the important thing. So here you may can ask a question. So why we are not starting with 1 to 1:30? Instead, we are going with 31 to 1:30. Why? Because I asked you earlier. That you have to memorize the values from what to where to where? 1 to 20. You have to memorize. And 21 to 30, I asked, I taught you the shortcut way to memorize the values. Do you remember it? Do you remember the shortcut, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yeah. Can I ask you the questions from that shortcut? Can I ask you the question? No, I'm not going to ask you the difficult questions. I'll ask you the simple question. Let's test your knowledge, right? Let's test your observing power, right? For example, 24 is paired with which number?
26.
Very good. Very good. 23 is paired with which number?
27.
Very good. Very good. 21 is paired with
29.
Final question. 25 is paired with.
Sir, it's alone.
It doesn't have a pair.
25 is paired with.
It's not
bad. It is alone. It is individual. Individual. So can anyone say me what is the value of 25 square?
25.
Very good. 25. Keep the 25 as it. Yeah, for 25 square, keep the 25 as it is and just place 6 before the 25. Keep the 25 as it is and just place 6 before the 25. It becomes us 625. So we can say the value of 25 square is what for us? 625. I hope you are clear up to this. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. No?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So 1 to 30, it's your part. You have to memorize it. 31 to 130, it's my part. I'll make you to memorize all those values. I'll make you to do the calculations mentally, right? So fine. Let's move on to the topic. Let's move on to the case. 31 to 130. Now listen carefully. 31 to 130, those values can be split into two groups, as I had mentioned in the diagram. As 31 to 74 is one case. And 76 to 130 is the second case, right? Now listen, for example, let me take a number, 48. Let's consider this number. Can I say 48 lies between the first set or the second set? The number 48 lies between the first set or the second set?
The first set.
31 to 74, it lies exactly between the first set, right? Now listen, can I say this 48 is nearer to 50?
Yes.
Yes,
sir. Yes.
What the value of 48? Yeah, very good. Somewhat the value of 48 is nearer to 50, isn't it? Similarly, those values, whichever is coming between 31 to 74, definitely what we can say is it also will have a base as 50, right? In simple words, what we can say, the values lying between 31 to 74 will have the base as 50, right? This is the point you have to keep in your mind. What's the base between the values of 31 to 74?
50.
Then look, without looking the PPT, just say me the value, say me the base value for those values between 76 to 130. What can be the base value between the values of 76 and 130?
100.
Obviously it should be 100, right? For 31 to 74, if it is 50, definitely we can say for 76 to 130, the base value will be what for us? 100. Are you clear with this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. It's a very simple idea. It's not a difficult one. We haven't entered into the concept. It's just a base. Just listen carefully. So this 50, which is our base, is an important thing, right? Yes, fine. Now listen, I'll test your memory power again. In our traditional method, we discussed an example of 46 square. Do you remember the square of 46? You no need to say me the method how to find the answer. Just say me. Do you remember the final answer alone? Let me check your mental.
2116.
Yeah, very good, very good. 46 square. The value what we got is 2116. Why am I asking this question is because I am going to take the same question again, right? I'm going to take the same value again by using the shortcut method. Right, listen. The shortcut, first I'm going to start with 31 to 74. For 31 to 74, we have the basis 50. That's the thing I had written here. That is 50. Now, listen, I'll ask you a simple question. Can anyone say me what's the value of 5 square?
25.
Very good. The value 25. Of 5 square is what? Very good. The value of 5 square is 25. Yes, very good. If 5 square is 25, can anyone say what is the square of 50?
125.
If not, yeah.
2500.
Right. Yes, very good. 5 square, listen. Yeah. Very good, very good. What the question I asked you to find the value for 50 square, right? 50 square is what for us? I can write it as 50 into 50.
So your voice 50. Is lagging. Isn't it?
5 into 5 is what for us? Place those two zeros as like this. Now is it clear for you? Now is it fine?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So now 5 into 5. What's the value of 5 into 5? It is 25.
25.
Very good. Still we have how many more zeros? Two more zeros, isn't it? So just place those two zeros as it is. So what's the final answer we are having?
2500.
So what's the value of 50 square? 50 square is 2500.
2500.
Very good. 2500. Right. Listen. Look at the PPT here. The first I had written a number 50. The next number I had written 2500 and I had striked out those two zeros. I had canceled those two zeros, isn't it? So that is an important point over here, right? Why here I choose 50? That's the first thing. Because the values between 31 to 74 will be nearer to 50. That's the first point. As that is the first point, we can consider 50 as our first base. 50 is our first base. So listen carefully to this point. 50 is our first base. The next one is what I find is 2500, which is nothing but square of 50. Square of 50 is 2500. And in that 2500, I am canceling the last two zeros. Why I'm canceling? In order to consider the second base as 25, not as 2500. The first base is 50 and the second base is 25. Guys, are you clear up to this?
Yes,
any doubt?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Very good. What's the first base? What's the first base?
50.
What's the second base?
25.
Now listen carefully to my instructions. You are going to find the answer for 46 square, 48 square, 37 square. Just listen to my instructions. Now, what's the first number I had considered? What's the first number I had taken in the example?
46.
Everyone, you have to reply with me. That is an important thing here, right? 46 square. We need to find the square of 46. Now, what you are going to do is, I'm not going to do anything. You are going to do everything. What you are going to do is, you are going to compare 46 with first base. When you are comparing 46 with 50, this 46 is more or less. Is 46 less. More or less when compared with 50?
Less.
46
less.
Is less. Less. Is it clear for everyone? Yes, right. 46 is less. How much it is less?
How much value it is less? Four.
Very good. We can say it is four less, right? Subtract, that is, it is less. So less that 4 in this 25. I'm going to subtract that lesser value 4 from this 25. If I subtract that 4 from 25, I'm going to subtract that 4 from 25. So 25 minus 4, what will be the value?
21.
That's the first two numbers I had written, 21. So could you see the PPT? Yeah, that is 21 is written over there. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Is it clear for everyone?
Yes,
yes, fine. So we subtracted 4 from 25 in order to get what? 21, right? That's the first part is completed. The second part is very simple, the most easiest one. How much value we subtracted from 25?
4.
Can anyone say square of 4 is what?
16.
That's the number I had placed over here. So that is your final answer. 21, that is 21, 25 minus 4. The next one is we are subtracting 4. So square of that 4 is 16. That is our final answer of 46 square. Is it clear for everyone?
Yes, it's clear.
Yes, sir.
Is it easier? Is this method is easy for you than the traditional method what we discussed previously?
Yes, sir.
Is it easy for everyone? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, very good. Not a problem. I'm going to erase everything what I had written on the PPT. Right now, we are going to do it again. Not for the same number, but for the next number, 48. You don't need to look at the PPT. Don't look at the PPT. Just listen to my instruction and say me the answer, right? So how many bases do we have?
Two bases.
Yes, very good. Very good. What are the two bases?
50 and 25.
50 and 25. What's the first base? 50. What's the first base?
50.
Yeah, very good. Very good. What's the second base? What's the second 25. Base?
25.
What is the second base?
25.
Yes, I'll be back. Yeah, right, fine. So the first base is what for us? It's 50. The second base is 25. Now listen, can you listen to me?
Yes, sir.
Now let's go for the next number, 48 square, right? You're going to send me the answer. 48, that number 48 square, we need to find the square of 48. 48 should be compared with which number first?
50.
Which base first?
50.
You're comparing, yeah, very good. You are comparing 48 with 50. Is 48 more or less than 50?
Less than 50.
How much value it is less?
Two numbers.
Two value it is less. So what you're going to do with this 2?
So 25 minus 2.
What's the value?
23.
Very good. Very good. How much value you subtracted?
Two.
What is square of 2?
Square of 2 is 4.
So listen. So here is an important point. So when I subtract 25 minus 2, we got a value as 23. But when I square the value of 2, which we subtracted from 25, the square of 2 is it's 4. If you place just a 4, the final answer becomes as 234, which cannot be a square of 48. So when you are squaring a number, that number should have 2 digits. That particular square value should have how many digits? 2 digits. So 2 square, which is 4. Yeah, very good. Two digits. 2 square, which is just simply 4, cannot be placed as 4. It should be placed as 0, 4. That is an important point you have to remember in this concept. Are you clear with this?
Yes, sir.
Number that is coming, the second one, the square root, the second one which is coming, we have to always put a 0 before the number. If it's coming just 1.
Yeah, if it is a single digit number, then always the single digit number will be preceded by 0. Is it clear now?
Okay, sir.
Okay, fine. Very good. Now, to have some more examples to make you more clear in the concept, I had took one more example. This is nothing but 37. Right. Now, listen, it is somewhat, it is not more easier than the previous two numbers. It is not more easy as like as the previous two examples. It is somewhat difficult because the difference is somewhat more when it is compared with 50. Not a problem at all, even though you can try to solve it. First, 37 square. We need to find the value for 37 square. I'm comparing with 50. Is 37 more or less than 50?
Less.
How much value it is less?
13.
Very good. 13. 25 minus 13, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
25 minus 13, what's the value?
12.
Very good. 12. 25 minus 12, what's the value? Oh, sorry, 25 minus 13, what's the value? It is
12.
12.
Yeah, very good. How much value subtracted from 25?
13.
I asked you to memorize the value for 13, isn't it? Now, if you couldn't make it, not a problem at all. After completing our sessions and after, when you're having the free time, you just memorize the values from 1 to 30. That is the mandatory part, as I said earlier. Right. 13 square. What's the value of 13 square? Can anyone try it out?
169.
Right. Previously, in the previous example, I taught you that whenever if you're going to square a number, that square number should have how many digits? It should have two digits. But here, in this 13 square, we have how many digits?
Three digits.
Very good. It's three digits. We cannot place it as it is 169. We cannot place 169 as it is. So what we are going to do is we are going to do a simple, a tricky way. That is, the regular procedure is I need to consider only the last two digits. What's the last digit? What for us?
69.
Place that 16 as it is. And now this one should be the carryover to the previous number 12. That is 12 plus 1. What's the value of 12 plus 1?
13.
So it becomes as 13, 69 as the answer for 37 square.
1369.
Very good. 1369. Is it clear for everyone?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Any doubt up to this?
No, sir. It's clear.
So always, while finding the square value of any number, after subtracting, you will be finding the square of that subtracted number. For example, in the case of 46, we subtracted 4 from 25. That is 21 we got, and we found the square of that 4. So while I find the square of 4, it is exactly what for us? 16. Here in this case, what we got is 16. The 16 is which? How much digit number?
Two digit number.
Yeah. Always the square value. What we are going to find, if it is two digit, it can be placed exactly. If it is a single digit number, how will you place that?
We have to add a zero before.
You need to consider zero before that number, right? If it's a three digit number, what are you going to do? If it's a three digit number, how are you going to do?
Carry over to the next number.
Which number should be the carryover?
The hundredths place.
This is your units place, tens place, and this is the hundredths place. Or in simple words, we can say the last two digits can be placed here, and the remaining number one, as you said earlier, that's the first position. This is the first position we can say. That is a technical term. So one should be the carryover for 12. Clear? Yes, fine. I'm clearing this. Now, listen carefully. The examples what I had considered here, 46, 48, 37, can I say all these three examples are less than 50?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. No. But look at the case. It's 31 to 74. Can I say there can be certain values which can be more than 50 or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, obviously it is yes, because the examples here I consider is just less than 50. But if you look at the case over here, can I say the examples what I had written on the PPT or what I had typed on the PPT is more than 50, isn't it?
Yes.
Yes. Now we are going to discuss the values, the squares of values, which is more than 50. You are going to say the answer. I'm not going to do anything else. My part is completed. I taught you the entire concept. You are going to do the concept. You are going to find the answer. Now listen, the same procedure, nothing is different. The same thing, you have to think and say me the answer, right? let's go with the first example. What's the first example? Can you say it?
56.
This 56 should be compared with which number?
100.
Guys,
100.
No. 50. Listen. 56. Is this 56 coming between 31 and 74 or?
Yes.
Is 56
yes,
is coming
yes,
between
sir.
31 and 74?
Yes.
Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Any value which is lying between 31 and 74 has a basis what?
50.
50. So the first base is what for us?
50.
What is the second base?
25.
So that is the thing. It should not get changed, right? The first base is what for us? 50. And the second base is what for us? 25. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So 56. Now come to the point. 56. It should be compared with which number?
50.
Very good. When 56 is compared with 50, is 56 more or less?
It's more than 50.
More. Very good. More. How much value?
By six,
right? 56 is more than 50 by six values, isn't it? Now listen carefully. In the previous set of examples, the values are lesser. For example, for 46, we have 4, which is lesser value. As 4 is less, what I did is, I did it as 25 minus 4. Here, the 4 is less, so we subtracted. But look at the case here. Is the 6 is less or more?
More.
It is more. We need to add with 25. That's an important difference between the previous two previous examples and this example. Are you clear with this difference?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. 25 plus 6. What is the value?
31.
We can say it is 31. Very good. 31. Right. How much value I added?
Six.
What is square of 6? 36. That's the answer. That is the square of 56. Are you clear?
Yes, sir.
So 56 square, we can say the answer is what for us? 31?
36.
Yes, right. Fine. Can I go with the next example? Any doubt up to this?
No, that's not any doubt.
Okay, fine. Very good. So now let's move on to the next one. 64. You are going to send me the answer. I'm not going to do anything else. You are going to send me the answers. So 64, right? 64. First, it should be compared with which number?
50.
Is it more or less?
More than 50.
How much?
14.
By 14.
That 14 should be done what? What we need to do with that 14?
It should be added
to 25.
What's the answer? What's the value you will be getting?
39.
Very good. We will get 39. What's the next procedure?
Find the square.
How much can you add?
Multiply 14.
14.
What is square of 14?
Square is
196.
Now comes an important point. In this 196, which number should be considered?
The first digit.
No, the last two digits should be placed as it is.
In the 196, the 100 digit.
It will be added to 39. It should be added to 39. 39 plus 1. What will be the value?
40.
And
96.
4096. Very good. So guys, so listen. I'll stop the session up to this. Before ending the session, I wanted to ask you something. Are you clear with the concepts what we discussed?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Very good. So the task here is, what you need to do is 1 to 30 squares. You have to memorize 1 to 30 squares. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
So you have to do this. This is mandatory part, right? And what you're going to do is, you can take random numbers between 31 to 74 and you can try to find the squares of those numbers. Clear? So I'll stop the session up to this. We'll continue the remaining part. That is here. I taught you only 31 to 74. This part is only we completed. We haven't touched this part. Let's do this part in the next session. Right. So first, make yourself more clear in this part, and then let's go for the second part and try to do as many different examples. If you have any doubts, let's discuss in the next class. Thank you, guys.
Welcome.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much, Dharagesh, sir. It was really such a wonderful session we had with you, sir. I have no words to say that your training, your teaching has brought us to our own school days itself. Wonderful and excellent training from you. Hope to have you again in our meeting, please. So
we'll contact
our president to have you again here. Because of lack of time, we need to continue further. Thank you so much.
Sure, ma'am. Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, sir. Let's move on to education session. Let's invite our first speaker, young leader Amita Varshini. She's studying in 9th grade in New Millennium School. Her hobbies are to do painting, making digital art, and she is a good debate speaker. She is going to be evaluated by our evaluator, young leader Shivan. She is a pensive YLP president. She is studying in the Asian school in 8th grade. She is a classical dancer, a good painter, and is interested in craft. Young leader Shivani, the floor is yours.
Thank you, MC. I want to tell my speaker the objectives of speech are select an appropriate outline which allows listeners to easily follow and understand your speech. Make your message clear with supporting material directly contributing in that message. Try to use the word of the day. Create a strong opening and conclusion. Try to speak 4 to 6 minutes. I wish my speaker all the best. Thank you.
Thank you, young leader Shivani. Over to young leader Amita Varshini.
Thank you, MC. So good evening, Madam Toastmasters, fellow Toastmasters, and all the guests present over here. So I'm here to deliver a speech on this topic. Demand is the first requirement for invention. So this is almost related to our meeting theme. So our meeting theme is necessity is the mother of invention. So this is said by Plato. So it is an also and famous proverb in the Aesop's fable. Everyone might have read it, right? So this means that when the need for something becomes essential and you're focused to find ways to get and achieve it. So that's the meaning for this proverb. So the best example for this proverb is the story of the crow and the pitcher story. So, which Jivita had already said in the introduction, so I would like to narrate it again. The crow which was flying was very thirsty. So, in the quest of water, he found a pitcher nearby and he went there. But he found that the water in the pitcher was very less. So, he instantly got an idea. So, he grabbed the pebbles near and he was pensive on throwing those pebbles in the pitcher. Then the water level rised. So he drank and his thirst was quenched and he flew happily. So understand, the necessity over here was to quench his thirst. In that situation, he invented a way of doing it. Same happens with all the humans. Till there is a need, you won't invent it. But if there is a demand, you're forced to invent those. So ultimately, demand is the first requirement for invention. So during this pandemic, it is a critical situation where it is very compulsory to provide education to all the students. Online class paved the way to provide education to students, which is an invention. So this online class could be only achieved by internet. What was the urge behind creating internet? Man's tremendous urge to attain this easily, attain things easily, and the thirst for knowledge made him do these all. So now he could access everything very easily and everything just by a simple click. This cycle has been continuing from Stone Age. For instance, take an example of the history of transport. First, we used to walk. Then we used to ride on animals such as horses and donkeys and etc. So then for riding, going for long distance and for transporting goods, we invented waterways, landways, and airways transports. So these all are interrelated. If one is found, it could be used in many other multiple ways. Man is never satisfied. He always aspires to have more. And it is rightly said, and I also believe that, satisfaction lies in efforts, not in the attainments. Full effort is full victory. This is said by Mahatma Gandhi. So the power of effort plays an important role. The effort is the agent which helps to discover inventions to meet the demand. So I would like to share my own personal experience. So the effort which I made achieve my long-term goal was this thought of mine was from my sixth grade onwards. So after the exams used to finish and I used to get promoted to the next grade, I used to ask the concept to myself again. I was unable to answer those questions. So past 2 years, I used to do the same and I ended up in a situation that I couldn't answer. So this time what I did, during the academic year itself, I started implementing those concepts in my daily routine, like the daily works I do, so that I don't forget those concepts, because 9th and 10th are related and I don't want to forget my concepts and I don't want to have the burden of studying that again. So for example, for boiling water also, I used to give a very large explanation and my mother used to get exaggerated. So these all turned humorous to myself. So I would like to conclude that each invention has caused humanity to progress and prosper. We must understand that the tremendous motivation, the necessity that has been created and the acknowledges for our efforts for making our life so much better for us are for the next future and success or an invention. Thank you. Over to the MC.
Wow, that was a really good speech. Thank you, young leader Amita Varshini. Let us continue with our education session with our second speaker, young leader Harini Kannan. She is studying in grade 4 in New Indian School. She likes to listen to music and sings well. She is always pensive in being happy and is very pensive in keeping others happy too. She is going to be evaluated by our evaluator, young leader Amita Loganathan. She is studying in grade 8 in Indian school. She is as pensive as her speaker in reading, singing, computing, drawing, listening to music, and as well as in dancing. She is so pensive that she has got first, second, and third prizes for dancing and singing. Young leader Amita, the floor is yours.
Thank you, Master of Ceremony. And my speaker is Harini Kannan. So I suggest her to give her speech in standing and to give some hand gestures and keep on body movement so that her speech is effective for the audience and it is not boring for this. And I suggest her also to give her speech for at least for 4 minutes to 4.5 and 5. And then I request her to not have any sort of fear with her and be confident. So I wish you very, very wishes all the best.
Thank you, young leader Amita. Now I call upon young leader Harini Kannan to start her speech.
Dear Bayati friends, respected Toastmasters and organizers, a warm good morning to good afternoon to all. Do you know when was Freedom from Fear of Speaking Day celebrated? It is celebrated every year on July 2nd. July 2nd is a very important day for Gavaliers and Toastmasters because we all gather here to meet the same objective to free ourselves from the fear of speaking. Have a note and keep it in your mind. July 2nd is a very important day for all of us and to me very special. It was a bright and a sunny day. The hospital was too busy. The couple were discussing with the doctor with Enkesti. The time for the delivery has came, but still there was no sign of pain for the young lady. The doctor recommended for an operation, but the couple refused and said, "We will wait for a normal birth." After 6 hours of waiting, the beautiful prince is born on July 2nd. The angel is none other than the person standing before you and breaking her eyes. I am Harini. I am studying in class 4 in New Indian School. As the name says, I am also new to the New Indian School. My father's name is Kannan. He works in Rampur. My mother's name is Uma. She takes care of our home. My sister's name is Srinidhi. She helps me in my studies. My hobbies are singing, painting, hearing music, reading stories, helping my mom. Special responsibility, fun time in charge at home. Additional responsibilities on interest, mischief monitor at home. Yes, inform to my mother, whoever doing mischief, especially my sister. I am here to make one point very clear. All the young ones of every family are born genius, expert. Don't ever try to mope with them. Most of the speeches, especially in icebreaker speech, I heard Gavaliers saying that they are bored, got irritated, feel tense, and angry because of their small sisters and brothers. They throw their pencils, pens, and notebooks. I want to say something very clear. We do this because you elders are not keeping your items in place, not organizing the things properly. Only for teaching you the proper way we throw things away. Only thing in our mind is we want the elders to be responsible. You may be elder, you may know many things, but we are smarter than you. Always the second child is more brilliant, more active, more creative than the elder. This creates the problem. Anyhow, at some point, you have to accept it. A very simple example. If your elders want to ask any permission, example, to go for a movie or a theme park, all request comes to the younger one, and the younger one would all the responsible to convince dad. Who have guts? My sister, even to extend the time for play in the evening, she asked me to convey my dad or mother. There is always a complaint that we are using your things like pencil, pen, paper. you elders could not digest it. But we always live in the concept the world is for everyone and sharing is the best character. My dream is I want to be a great scientist. I want to invent a new thing that will be helpful for the people. I want to create a robot which does everything I say. Can be used in emergency to save people in fire or flood. My father used to say that I like to always be perfect in my home. If my father leaves the cupboard door open, I come and scold him to close it properly. Even the doormat is not in position, I used to collect it. I want all the people in this world to be happy and peaceful. I will do all my effort to make others happy. So they call me as Happy Harini. Thank you.
The thing that you told about young ones are really true. Thank you, young leader Harini. I now invite a third speaker of the day, Jairam. He is studying in grade 7 in Asian school. He is very pensive in solving Rubik's Cube, reading story books, playing football, cricket, and chess. He wants to improve his speaking skills, communication, and knowledge from this youth leadership program. He wants to become an engineer when he grows up. Our third speaker, Jairam, is going to be evaluated by our evaluator, young leader Kanishka. She is also studying in the 7th grade in Asian school. She keeps herself pensive by drawing, dancing classical dances, and reading books. Young leader Kanishka, the floor is yours. Young leader Kanishka.
Ma'am, Kanishka is having some network issues. She will join in September.
She has joined.
Young leader. Sorry for the delay, ma'am.
No issues, Kanishka. I can proceed with.
Yeah. Good evening once again to everyone. Today, I will be evaluating the speech of our speaker, Jairam. The objectives for his speeches, he have to select a speech topic and determine its general and specific purpose. And I hope that you will keep in touch with us with your eye contact and your body movements. Organize your speech and try not to use notes. I wish all the best for my speaker. Thank you.
Everyone present here. I'm here to give a speech about a very important topic which is much related to our today's theme. Necessity is the mother of inventions. I would like to take this opportunity to thank our MC by selecting this theme. I felt more pensive than ever. As I was preparing my speech, I end up choosing a topic which fortunately matched with our theme of the day. And that is, should recycling be mandatory? Did you know your choice to recycle is one that could change the world? By reducing your carbon footprint, you are playing a vital role in saving the environment. Yes, I feel that more invention is required in recycling field. Recycling takes material that would otherwise be considered waste and remanufactures these items to create new products. The more people choose to recycle, the greater impact recycling will have. As a result, it's important that every individual contributes to recycling efforts. For this reason, recycling should be mandatory. recycling saves natural resources. Recycling is an important strategy in conserving the world's scarce natural resources. Recycling reduces the need for landfills and other disposable facilities, thereby need for allowing local lands to be used in more environmentally preferable ways. By substituting scrap materials for the use of trees and metal ores and minerals. While recycling, we must remember the three R's. The first R stands for reduce. The second R stands for reuse. The third R stands for recycle. The recycling process involves in three main steps. Number one, collecting the recyclables. Number two, processing the recyclables to products, and it won't stop there. Finally, number three, purchasing of recycled products plays a major role. Here are some benefits to be obtained from recycling. Reduces the amount of waste sent to landfills. Saves natural resources. Reduces pollution. Recycling helps reduce climate problems. Recycling saves energy. For instance, a study says recycling aluminium cans saves more than 95% of energy. Approximately 30% of energy is saved from recycled glass, and 40% of energy is saved when paper is recycled, and millions of trees can be saved. Recycling is good for the economy. Energy is expensive, and many of our energy sources are being depleted. Overall, there are many benefits to be derived from recycling. The world has changed very much, and the amount of waste produced is rapidly increasing. It's important to note that municipal waste collected from house accounts for just 10% of the total waste. Other types of waste includes agricultural waste, medical waste, and industrial waste. The human population has grown, making more purchases than before, and much of the new packaging is not biodegradable. In particular, plastic is accumulating in landfills and in oceans. It will take over 400 years to degrade. Even the developed nations are struggling in recycling their waste. Countries will have to come up with strong policies and sustainable waste management practices. Otherwise, there won't be enough resources. This necessity has put all nations in a pensive attitude. How can nations catch up? The report claims success is about changing attitudes, and the country's policies should make people to follow strictly. The decrease in natural resources and increase in unemployment are the topmost issues, which put all nations in pensive mode. If more research and development made in recycling industry, the results can be staggering in terms of saving natural resources and creating employment. So, invent ways to adopt, recycle in your life, and do your part from today. Finally, I finish my speech with the hope that I too made all of you more pensive than ever before for a better future. Thank you.
Thank you, young leader Jaira, for your proactive speech. I would now like to conclude this education session with our speaker, young leader Akshara. She is studying in the fourth grade in Alnur International School. Her hobbies are doing artworks, drawing, playing with friends. She is very pensive in dancing and crafts. She will be evaluated by our evaluator, young leader Gautam. He is studying in Asian School in the eighth grade. He is very pensive with the technology, as his hobbies are animating, video making, online art making, posters, and more. He is so pensive to achieve his ambition of becoming a robotic engineer. Young leader Gautam, please advise your speaker.
Hello, I'm Gautam and I am the evaluator for Akshara. She is going to give the icebreaker speech. I suggest Akshara to tell the speech as best as she can, having body gestures, speech grammar, eye contact, speaking on the right time, good voice, and speak fearlessly. All the best to Akshara for the icebreaker speech. Thank you and over to MC.
Thank you, young leader Gautam. Young leader Akshara, you may now commence with your speech.
Thank you, Gautam. Good evening, everyone. I am Akshara Chattivel and I am here for my speech in your leadership program. My heartfelt greetings to fellow club members and young leaders in YLP, and I am happy to join with you all. I was pensive for a moment after hearing three wonderful speeches. The journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step. I am grateful student of Aldon International School as I am the first kin, so I am a little pampered too. We are from state of Tamil Nadu, India. We are of four, my dad, mom, and my little brother. Myself and my brother are born and brought up in Bahrain. My dad, Mr. Shafiwil, is working here in Bahrain as a manager of private electrical contracting company for past 18 years. My dad is not strict but perfect example to me. His words, don't do for audience, do for you. His reason of myself. Evaluation here, self-realization happens out of deep understanding by your own experience. My mom's name is Aarti. As per my mom's perspective, I'm going a little low in my confidence while expressing thoughts into words, so obviously she is the reason why I'm here. The best gift I received so in my life is my little brother Adarva Shaktiel, who is 4 years old now and held responsible for my laughter, joy, and tears too during this pandemic time. As my field of interest and hobbies grew together when playing chess, dancing, doing art and craft works, and I love to play with my friends Davini and Sonini in our building, I got 2 belts in Taekwondo and practicing Western in Aryan's dance studio. I love to read books too. I'm signing off by thanking all the young leaders, coordinators, guests, and all club members present in this meeting. Let's all stay safe and continue with our prayer for the better environment all over the world. Thank you.
Thank you, young leader Akshara. Our most awaited session is here. Please join me in calling our table topics master, young leader Nainika. She is studying in the 2nd grade in Alnur International School. She is interested in dancing and listening to music, but way more pensive in sports like basketball, running race, and is a best swimmer. Young leader Nainika, please take over the table topics session.
Thank you, MC, Youth Leader Jeevita, for your wonderful introduction. Good evening to Senior Toastmaster, YLP Coordinator and Youth Leaders and lovely guests. The purpose of the Topic Master is to facilitate Table Topic Master and is to topic where guests and members will have the opportunity to practice their impromptu speaking. I will introduce our topic and call on speakers who will be given 2 minutes to speak on the subject. Excuse me, Auntie. I need to share my screen. Can I have access?
Yes, dear, you can have your access from our president.
Okay.
Yeah, done, Nainika.
Done, Nainika, you can proceed.
The first question goes to youth leader Shahita. The topic is youth leader Shahita.
Yes.
The topic is what activity or sport are you afraid to try?
Thank you, Table Topic Master, for giving this opportunity. So the question asked to me is, what sports or activity you're afraid to try is? I am afraid to try swimming because of water, of course, and if you by mistakenly fell down or something, oh my God. I can't imagine. So the thing which I'm afraid to do is swimming. So thank you, Table Topic Master, for giving this opportunity.
Thank you for your amazing speech, youth leader Shahita. The next topic goes to youth leader Shivani.
Yes, Table Topic Master.
The topic is, describe your dream vacation. The stage is yours.
Thank you, Table Topic Master. Good evening to one and all. The question asked to me is, describe my dream vacation. I'm a person who likes summers and all types. So I would be like to go a summer vacation. I would like to go Bahamas, where this beach, sand, I would like to go for London, the Disneyland, because my dream is to be from childhood to now onwards, I would always ask my parents on my birthday, can we go to Disneyland? Because when I was child itself, I'm a fan of all the characters of princess, and I really wanted to meet them in Disneyland. And you will be having many fun rides. And one of my scariest ride is a roller coaster. But I wanted to try roller coaster in my own Disneyland, which when you go to Disneyland, the roller coaster, it won't be even afraid. It would be more interesting and would be enjoying when you're going for your dream vacation and you're in the dream London. And I would like to go to London because I would take many photos with many princess Disney characters, and it would be very memorable for me as a childhood. So I would like to say that my dream vacation is to go to London. Thank you.
That was amazing speech, youth leader Shivani. The next topic goes to youth leader Kanishka.
Yes, Table Topic Master. Good evening, everyone. Thank you, Table Topic Master, for giving this question to me.
The question is, if you get power to chance, if you get power to change the world, what will you do?
Thank you, Table Topic Master, for this question. Once again, good evening, everyone, in this meeting. The topic given to me is, if you get power to change the world, what will I do? In this present COVID-19 situation, if I could change something in the world, I could change the coronavirus. And I am bored to sit at home in this coronavirus time. And lockdown here, lockdown there, everywhere, lockdown, lockdown. Heard that in the news, this many people died in a day. To hear that, I was shocked. Oh my God, is there that many people who are sick? Is there that many people who die every day? This coronavirus is totally irritating, you know. We are scared to go out. We are scared to stay in home. Oh my God, if I could change and if I get the power, you know, I won't even think of doing what that would help me. But if I get that power, really I am saying that I will try to change this coronavirus. Thank you, Table Topic Master.
That was amazing speech, youth leader Kanishka. The next topic goes to youth leader Prince Calvin. You say the Prince Calvin? Are you there?
Any topic, Master? Prince Calvin is not here. You can go to the next.
Okay. The next topic. This topic goes to Faisal. Youth leader Faisal.
Yes, table topic, Master.
The question is, if you won a grand prize in lucky draw of 1,000 media, how could you use it?
A very good evening to one and all. The question given to me as by the topic master is, if you won a grand lucky draw of 1,000 BD, how could you use it? Many people might spend it at the a prize for themselves. Many people will just donate it. Many people will give it to their mother or father. I'll just give the money away to my mother. Yes, or I will buy my father's dream car for him. That we will do. And even give the whole money to my father. Yes, that's what I'll do.
You are muted, Nainika.
Then the next topic goes to youth leader Varshini.
Yes, table topic, Master.
The question is, if you had the chance to go back in time, change on thing, would you do it?
Thank you, table topic master, for this wonderful topic. So, good evening, Madam Toastmasters, fellow Toastmasters, and all the guests present over here. So, the table topic given to me is, if you had the chance to go back in time and change one thing, what would you do? So, this was, which I will change is, in my academic years of grade 1 and 2, I didn't even know that there's something called awards, which was given for, you know, for excellence studying. So if I went back in time, so I would tell that, you dumb Amrita, go check your almanac. There's something called achievement award. Go check it. Because first and second grade, I didn't even know that there's something called achievement award. So I didn't even know about that. And That was my responsibility. I had to check my almanac, but I didn't do that. If I checked it, I would have got my achievement award. So when I got to know about that in third grade, then only that was my first time when I got my achievement award. So I would like to tell that past Amrita, if I went back in time, I would tell her to check her almanac and be responsible. So thank you over to the table topic master.
Thank you for your speech, for your amazing speech. The next topic goes to YLP coordinator Durga Aunty.
Yes,
the topic is, are you happy with yourself?
Thank you so much, table topic master, youth leader Nainika. And thank you for the wonderful question given to me. or am I happy with myself? But definitely I would say I'm happy with myself because I've got a good family, good husband, good daughter, and all of the at most all of the above. I've got the youth leaders like you to whom I was being a coordinator, and I was really happy to have Nainika as a table topic master today and performing really good at this age. So what I should have more than this to be happy more enough. And you have what is that addressed me among you? I hope, I don't think so, that I can able to cope up with you, compete with you, with these with you people, you young leaders. I couldn't give this much that much answer what you are doing. So I was really very happy with my own work, and I'm really happy with you people. Thank you so much, Table Topic Master. Thank you for this wonderful question to me. Back to you.
That was an awesome speech. Thank you, Andy. Thank you for this opportunity. Over to MC.
Thank you, young leader Nainika, for such a wonderful session. To evaluate our whole session, I now invite our general evaluator, Toastmaster Tamil Selvi. Toastmaster Tamil Selvi is a MCA graduate and is also proud mother of our young leader, Akash Shaktiwal. She is a home economist and is currently the VPPR manager in Division I. Toastmaster Tamil Selvi, the floor is yours.
Ma'am, you're muted.
You're muted.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, Master of Ceremony. Good evening to all Toastmasters, young leaders, and all guests. This is the evaluation session of our meeting. First, we will hear timer report for all our four wonderful speakers. Timer, young leader Akash Shaktiwal, over to you.
Speaker number one, young leader Amita Rashmi, 5 minutes, 12 seconds. Second speaker, YLP Harini, young leader Harini, 6 minutes, 35 seconds. Young leader Jairam, 5 minutes, 70 seconds. Young leader Akshara Shaktiwal, 2 minutes, 32 seconds.
Thank you, timer, for your report. Now we will call speech evaluators to give evaluation of today's prepared speeches. Then I will give my general evaluation of the overall meeting today. Our first evaluator is young leader Shivani. She is going to evaluate young leader Amita Varshini's speech, demand the first requirement of invention. Please help me to welcome young leader Shivani.
Thank you, general evaluator. Once again, good evening to one and all. Today, I'm going to evaluate my speaker, Amita Varshini's speech. Your topic is demand the first requirement of invention. This is an interesting and a wonderful topic. Your speech shows that you have researched a lot about your topic and you have used nice models, quotes, points, and you share your own experience. Your speech was very pensive and was clear to understand and listen. Your body movements. It is a plus point that you stood up and spoke, which was very interacting with the audience. Your time is 5 minutes 12 seconds, which is a perfect time for the speech. You covered all the important points in your speech, which within your time limit. Your modulation. You spoke very loud at some places, which I really loved. Your eye contact. While you were speaking, you were slightly seeing downwards,
So for your next speech, try to face the camera or try to look forward. And you use the word of the day. Sure, without these inventions, human being cannot live in this world. These inventions, example, you told internet and you told transportations. Internet, without internet, can you think that we could survive this lockdown or this COVID-19 pandemic? This COVID-19 pandemic this lockdown shows us internet is very important for online and online shopping, online schools. And it is very important for having internet. Without internet, we couldn't have the computers, phones, laptops, and etc. Transportations. Do you think without transportations, the world would be good or would it be nice? If transportation is there, it would be very easy to go one place to another. Other than that, you had done an excellent job and you had followed all my objectives. And you used one quote for Mahatma Gandhi, which it was really good. All the best for your upcoming speeches. Thank you. Over to you, Gender Evaluator.
Thank you, young leader Shivani, for your well evaluation. Our second evaluator is young leader Amita Loganathan. She is going to evaluate young leader Harshini icebreaker speech. Let's all put together to welcome young leader Amita Loganathan. Over to you.
Thank you, General Eval. So I'm going to, as she had gave her speech in a very good manner, more than I thought of. And my speaker would have used hand gestures and her body movement was perfect. And she was very confident. And her, she explained everything in good manner as she started from her small age to higher grades. And she explained about her siblings, her parents, and everyone. That was good. And she was in the correct timing. And I guess she did not use the word of the day. From her next speech, she would have used that, and from her next speech, this speech she was looking to her script on her full speech, but I request her to avoid it from her next speech. Thank you.
Thank you, young leader Amita Loganathan, for your evaluation. Our third evaluator is young leader Kanishka. She is going to evaluate young leader Jairam. Speech, should recycling be mandatory? Let's welcome her. Over to Kanishka.
Okay, General Evaluator. Good evening once again to everyone. How was young leader Jairam's speech on the topic, should recycling be mandatory? Wow, the topic he has chose was a fabulous topic. Yes, the speech topic he selected was a very good topic. And the way he organized the speech, the beginning, the body, and the conclusion was amazing. And his speech shows that how sincere and convict he was in his speech.
Yes, I think that he didn't use any notes. And his eye contact, his voice modulation, we could find his confidence in his voice modulation itself. Yes, but some suggestions to improve your speech. You could have stood up and you would have given your speech standing up. Because if you stand up, without you unknowingly, you will get the hand gestures, the body movements, and everything. The suggestion which I told now was just a small mistake in your speech. You could have stood up and gave more hand gestures in your speech. Your confidence was very good. We could find the confidence in your voice itself. Your voice modulation was very good. Thank you. Over to the general evaluator.
Thank you, young leader Kanishka, for your wonderful words. Our fourth evaluator is young leader Gautam. He is going to evaluate Akshara Shaktivel speech, icebreaker speech. Please help me to welcome young leader Gautam. Over to young leader Gautam.
Hello everyone. I'm Gautam and I'm going to be evaluating Akshara's speech. Akshara, well, you're giving such a wonderful and nice speech, but your speech voice was a bit low, but very clear. Your eye contact need to be improved by facing the meeting in the next session. Your body language also needs to be improved since you didn't show any body language. Next time, please try to improve these any try to make your speech very attractive. Now, the speech time you gave was 2 minutes and 25 seconds. Honestly, you could have added more points to your speech. Since it was under the speech minimum, which is 4 minutes. Now, let's go on to the speech. Even though your speech wasn't very clear, I was able to get some points about you life in the speech. As you said, you are from Tamil Nadu. You live with your father, mother, and your brother. You said your father works as a manager in a contracting company. You said you help your mother as well, which is a very good thing of you. Your hobbies are very interesting. Also, Akshara didn't use the word of the day. Also, your confidence level was great. I suggest Akshara to tell the speech next time as best as you can, having body gestures, speech grammar, eye contact, speaking on the right time, good voice, and to speak fearlessly. Thank you.
Thank you, Young Leader Gautam, for your evaluation. Can I get timing report for evaluators and table topic participants? Timer Aga Shaktivel.
Young leader Shivani, 2 minutes, 37 seconds. Young leader Amita Logarangan, 1 minute, 40 seconds. Young leader Kanishka, 1 minute, 23 seconds. Young leader Gautam, 1 minute, 48 seconds. Table topic participants. Young leader Shahita, 25 seconds. Young leader Shivani, 1 minute 40 seconds. Young leader Kanishka, 1 minute 6 seconds. Young leader Faizul Rahman, 57 seconds. Young leader Amita Vashini, 1 minute 60 seconds. Toastmaster Durga Deva, 1 minute 10 seconds. Over to Master General Evaluator.
Thank you, young leader Akash Shaktivel, for your timer report. We will take all the speakers, all the evaluators and table topic participants as a qualified, can you comments over this? We'll consider all qualified.
Yeah, we will have everyone because they have improved a lot this time. Evaluation also done greatly. So we can have Madam General Evaluator. Over to you.
YLP coordinator.
Thank you.
Here goes our today meeting evaluation. The meeting begin at 7:25 PM. We started the meeting 1 minute earlier. It's really appreciable one. And the meeting running little delayed due to some our workshop. Otherwise, everything as per the agenda, it's great. Secretary at OMS started the meeting and he warmly greeted the guest and he hand over the meeting to the YLP president, Shivani.
Madam General Evaluator, sorry for the interruption. Actually, we couldn't see you properly. If you just move a little while toward right side, we can.
Okay.
Yeah, thank you so much.
YLP President Shivani opened the meeting well. She welcomed the YLP XCOM members for business session. And due to some issue, our YLP VP is not present. She apologized for that. We accepted that. So that part was missed, no problem. Otherwise, the business meeting went well within the allotted time. She welcomed and handed over the meeting to the Master of Ceremony, Young Leader Jeevita. The agenda was well prepared with enough information. Master of Ceremony had a proper opening with a beautiful theme, Necessity is the Mother of Invention. She started with a Thirsty Crow story. It really attracted all of us. And she introduced the meeting theme. She gave well explanation about the theme. She gave more about the theme. She properly introduced all the speakers and the evaluators in well manner. Yeah. Well done, Master of Ceremony, Young Leader Jeevita.
Thank you, ma'am.
Come to the speakers. All speakers are well spoken and had a close track on their topics. Really appreciable, tremendous improvement in our young leaders, all young leaders. And Young Leader Amita Varshini, she spoken on the topic Demand the First Requirement of Invention. Her speech title and our today meeting team are interconnected due to internet issues. Some of us missed hearing Thursday story. Again, we got second opportunity to hear the same story from our young leader, Amita Varshini. Really, she started her speech with a story. It's appreciable and well job, Amita Varshini. And our next speaker, little one, Young Leader Harshini, she gave icebreaker speech. We heard your beautiful princess story from her. Thank you so much, Young Leader Harshini. She given her speech in the correct timing, more than 6 minutes. It's really appreciable. And next speaker, Young Leader Jairam. He's spoken on the topic, should recycling be mandatory? It's really a very useful topic, awesome speech. He's spoken related to the topic. It's really very interesting and we really enjoyed your speech. And our next speech speaker, little one, Young Leader Aksara. She spoken very well. Well said, Akshara. Don't do for audience. Do it for you. Really, you said well. She spoken now. Very structured. She gave a very structured speech. And coming to evaluation part, all our evaluators did a great job. All evaluators given positive and recommendation for all the speakers. So great work done by our evaluators. Now I would like to hear a report from today our counter, young leader Sai Aravind. Over to you, Sai Aravind. Young leader Sai Aravind.
Thank you, General Evaluator. Young leader Amita Varshini used 3 times so and used 1 time. Young leader Amita so 1 time used so 1 time. Young leader Harini used 2 times her. Young leader Jayaram saw 2 times. Young leader Gautam, okay. Young leader Kaniska, okay. All else okay. Thank you.
Thank you, young leader Sai Aravind, for your wonderful report. Now I would like to share report from today grammarian, young leader Faizur Rahman. Over to you.
Good evening, everybody. Thank you, General Evaluator, for giving the opportunity to read the grammarian report. Today, the word of the day, pensive, was used very less, which is a big of a disappointment. Young leader Jairam used it 2 times. And young leader Akash Akshara used it 1 time. Or MC used it the most. Young leader Amrita Varshini had a quote of Mahatma Gandhi. She has told a quote about Mahatma Gandhi. Over to General Evaluator. Thank you.
Thank you, young leader Faizur Rahman, for your wonderful grammarian report. Next, our little table topic master, young leader Nainika. She introduced the table topic session purpose in well manner. All the topics were easy to understand by our participants. Really great work, young leader Nainika. Well done.
Thank you.
I was very pensive towards this session because this table topic session is really engaged and entertained one. Again, great work by our young leader Nainika. Today, about our today workshop session on Vedic Maths is done by aptitude faculty, Mr. Darakeshwar. He made this workshop session very interactive and very interested way. It's really very useful session for all our young leaders. Our all young leaders enjoyed it and definitely they gained more knowledge about Vedic Maths. Thank you, sir, for giving this wonderful concept for our young leaders. Overall, the meeting is pensive. I really enjoyed each and every corner of this meeting. Thank you for giving this wonderful opportunity. Now I return my meeting control to Master of Ceremony, young leader Jeevita.
Thank you, Toastmaster Tamilselvi, for evaluating our session. Thank you all, and over to our YLP president, young leader Shivani.
Thank you, MC. Today's meeting, thank you today's Ginger Evaluator, Toastmaster Tamil Selvi, and four wonderful speakers, Table Topic Masters and Evaluators and Role Players. You all did an excellent job. I hope you all enjoyed today's meeting, and thank you all for attending our meeting today. With energetic, this meeting is urgent. Thank you.
So I am getting some questions like, what about the best speaker? What about the best evaluator? So everybody will be announced as best speakers, best table topic presenters, and best evaluators. As you all know, no one is far behind or no one is forward than others. Sorry? So I take privilege and I take this opportunity to thank each and everyone, as I was really very happy about today's meeting because we have improved a lot from the day one. We were just traveling together and I could see more improvement in each and every one of our young leaders. It was really making me happy. As young leader Nainika asked me the question, what makes you too happy? So I'm just here clearly saying that it is making me very happy today. Purposively I'm saying, because last time we have just pointed out with certain recommendations and suggestions, both from our outside general evaluator, like outside the Toastmasters experience, Toastmaster, as well as I have just put forward for, please adhere to your own timing. So I think most of our recommendations have been fulfilled, our own youth leaders. I was really very happy to be a YLP coordinator for these kind of talented kids. So we are just close to our end meeting of this wonderful session. So little worried about being closing this wonderful session with you all kids. So we'll just take it as a grand ending up of our own YLP session number 8. So for that, I hope to have everyone as volunteers. So please come up with your own roles and speeches. Don't expect me to ask you personally. So we are just planning to have as a debate session. Our 8th session will be like a debate session, and volunteers are as always welcome. So thank you so much, kids. Thank you. And over to Mr. President. I would like to hear it from our president. And special thanks to our general evaluator, Toastmaster Tamil Selvi, who have just given her reports in an appreciable way. Thank you so much, Madam general evaluator. And here comes our president. Can we hear it from our president, please?
Yeah, thank you very much, our chief coordinator. Actually, we are in the end of the session. Two sessions, first 4 session and next 4 session, going well. Actually, really, we enjoyed a lot. We are very happy with you all young leaders, but this is not the end. This is just a beginning, because our next program of this youth leadership is going to continue in Tamil language, our mother tongue. So better we are going to enjoy in our mother tongue without any gap. So this will be coordinated by our club ESCOM peoples. So it's not yet, but we will have in the 8th session debate and more useful sessions, like some DTMs would like to give more brief about the public speaking and body language improvement, So we will get the timing from them for the next session. So before that, I am requesting someone to please take up the role for master of ceremony, as already table topic master is reserved by Gautam.
Excuse me, uncle.
Yes.
So can I be MC for next session?
So Faizuri is MC. Fine. Okay. And Nainika?
Excuse me, uncle. Any role is there?
No, all role is open.
Mr. President, actually, very sorry to say that MC role have been taken by Shivani, young leader Shivani already. Just
okay.
Reserved for that. So very sorry to Faizur Rahman as he is coming up. Very sorry, we need to give preference to the first comer. First comers, don't be disheartened. But you can play a role. You can play as speaker as well, a role of speaker as well. So just
this is a debate session, so debate speaker, right?
Okay, sir, I'll be speaker.
Okay, debate.
Don't get disheartened, Faizur. So as we are having upcoming session as well, you can be MC.
So what about Nainika? Which role?
I want to be the timer.
Okay.
And Kanishka has asked for timer.
But Kanishka should be debate participant because
any role.
Any role?
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, Shivani, you just please make a note of the role players, and Nainika will be playing the role of timer. And Kanishka will be the debate presenter. Faizur Rahman will be the debate presenter. We will just make a group. Once after making the group, we will just finally conclude.
Sorry, can I be the speaker for the next session?
Can I be the speaker?
Yeah. All can speak as a debate speaker. All can speak.
Can I also?
Who's that? Jeevita. Jeevita. Jairam.
Excuse me.
Sahida.
Yes, Jeevita wants to be speaker. Jairam wants to be speaker, debate speaker. Then who else?
Sahida.
Amit Tavashini wants to be debate speaker. So we will just make three.
Can I guess is debate speaker?
I also want to be a speaker.
Yeah, Faizur already noted. Then who else?
Okay. Can I be the debate speaker?
Who's that? Shagita?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, Shagita. Hope Shivani is noting down.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, dear. So, Amit Tavashini, Shagita, Faizur, Jeevita, then Jairam.
Shaheta.
Who's that?
Shagita.
Teacher, can I also be a speaker? Excuse me, auntie, if Kanishka want to be the timer, can I be the grammarian?
Who's asking? I couldn't get it from you.
Nainika.
Nainika, what else?
Grammarian.
You want to be grammarian? You want to be grammarian?
Yes, grammarian. Not timer. Let Kanishka be the timer.
Kanishka will be the speaker. She is not here with us, I think.
She is not here because her internet is not stable. But we can convince her as a speaker, debate speaker.
Okay, if you want to take up the role as timer, you take.
I want to be the grammarian.
You want
ma'am, I can take up the role of timer.
No, Jeevita, who is the timer?
Yes, sir, Jeevita.
No. It could be a speaker, debate speaker.
Akshara, you want to take any role here?
Kanishka and Jeevita, Shivani, Sahita, Amirza Varsani, Faizur, all combined section students should be debate speaker.
Okay. Yes, of course. Since it was the last meeting, we will be having chief guests from outside. So better we can have the elder ones. So it will make the session live.
Yes. So better the junior young leaders should be a role player. Senior young leaders should be a debate speakers.
Akshara, do you want to say something? You want to play any role?
Excuse me, auntie. I told that I want to be the grammarian.
Okay, dear. You were noted as the grammarian. Don't worry.
Please
you will
confirm.
Be playing the role of grammarian.
Maybe she selected the word of the day.
Teacher.
Yes, baby.
Ananya.
Teacher, can I be the timer?
Yes, yes.
You want to be the timer?
Yeah, good.
Yes, good. Teacher.
That's good.
Okay. Shivani, note it down. We will finalize at last.
Okay, ma'am. Ma'am, is Shivani MC going to be the moderator too?
No, no, no. Moderator will be arranging from outside.
Yes.
He will be the elder one. Toastmaster.
Okay, ma'am.
So just prepare yourself. We'll just make it as a grand session there for our 8th. It's a complete completion, complete, what is that? Sorry, ending session now. So we'll make it as a grand one.
Yeah.
So just prepare yourself.
Timing should be little more because not 1.5 hour, maybe 2 hour.
Absolutely now, but today they have crossed nearly 5-6 minutes also. Many speakers have given more than 6 minutes. Really,
that is appreciable. Yeah.
Yes. So now they got up. Actually, since because of that long break, now they have forgot everything. So now it's time for them to recollect and recover from that. So they were doing fine comparatively than 5th and 6th meeting. This meeting we could see a lot more improvements from
yes,
them.
Yes.
Hi, yes, ma'am. There is a lot of problem today with my laptop. I don't know what happened. So I'm getting disconnected. It's the 5th time I'm getting disconnected.
No issues, Kanishka. Always welcome with you. You have been noted as a debate speaker, so no need to worry. You will be in our list.
Okay. Next meeting will be in English, right?
Yes, yes, of course, absolutely.
Is it a debate speech, ma'am, or just normal speech? Debate speech, right?
Debate speech, yeah. Just
okay,
like what we had in our 4th session, 3rd session, I think.
Yes, ma'am, that's family or society.
Yes, just like that we'll be having.
Okay, ma'am, okay, ma'am, okay.
Yeah.
Ma'am, when is the next session going to be?
That we will finalize and let you know soon.
Okay, ma'am. Ma'am, please watch the topic as soon as possible.
Definitely, definitely. In case if a topic gets delayed, now you'll be giving enough time for preparation. Don't worry.
Okay, ma'am. Ma'am, could you tell the time criteria?
Oh, yeah, we'll be having a time criteria, so it's a special time criteria as well. But I will just go through with that YLP book and I'll let you know.
And is it going to be like the last debate session or is it going to be the normal one like everyone?
No, this is going to be the 2-round session. Actually, debates in Toastmasters and all will be in two, like the start should end. Actually, that captain of that particular team has to end up that session. So we'll have like that only. Hope you have seen in TVs and all how that Pattimandiram and all happens now. Just like that it will be. The captain has to start up and end up. Like that, the captain will be having 2 sessions.
Okay, ma'am.
Yeah. The thing is, the major purpose of debate session, you all know, I have already told you, we have just gone through also, the counter is most important. It's not like a prepared speech. We can give a prepared speech, that is good. But then too, we have to allot a specific timing. See, what we will do in our Toastmaster meeting means we will be having every individual speaker will have two slots, 2 sessions to talk. in which one session will be giving our own prepared speech, and the next one will be giving the counter part. That means we will be giving a counter speech for the speaker, those who have just given speech before me. That means before one. Hope you understood. Okay, so like that it will be. So we will discuss that, how we can keep, because as you are grown up, so as we are going to have the elder one, so we can have that part also, I think. But we will just discuss and we will let you all know soon.
Okay, ma'am.
When is the next session? As I said already, we will just finalize it and get back to you, Gautam. Okay.
So that's it. Tamil YLP sessions will continue after the 8th one.
Yeah, yes. You're right. Yeah.
Once after the 8th one. Yeah.
Okay.
We'll officially close this English YLP session and we will start off the Tamil one.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. So hope you all got the idea. So we will just work together to make our YLP English a great success. So as usual, I'm just expecting the same cooperation from you all, young leaders. You are just so wonderful, so great. You are just putting your effort. But then too, as a YLP coordinator, I'm just requesting again you all to come up with the great exposure next meeting. Thank you so much. Shall we end up now?
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Bye, good night.
Thank you all. Thank you all very much.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. Bye.
Thank you, ma'am.